Before I had heard about the neurodiverse hiring program, there's a fear that like traditional interviews are very difficult or that it's really hard for somebody with like Asperger's to land a big tech job.
Traditional hiring practice expects you to understand the natural expectations of the interview itself. You're expected to communicate in a certain way. Whereas the neurodiversity hiring program removes those barriers. You're no longer spending your energy on trying to navigate it. You're there spending your energy on how do I demonstrate the skills that they want to see.
There was interview prep, practice, just learning about the company, Microsoft's commitment to neurodiversity, what it would be like to work here.
We run regular hiring events for roles in our corporate offices. Everything from engineering to program management, customer service, sales, and finance. In 2024, we expanded our program into data centers across the U.S.
With the Neurodiversity Hiring Program at Microsoft, it helped me realize that my way of thinking is very valuable. I remember I was able to schedule a one-on-one with someone. She helped me get ready for my interview and help address any anxieties or worries I had. And when I went to my interview, I was not afraid at all. I was very confident.
If you need a distraction-free work environment or dim lighting, things like that, you can ask for it.
I requested a pair of noise-canceling headphones, and I find that that helps me stay focused and on task at work. Another accommodation I never asked for, but very grateful for, is Copilot. Being able to take notes during a meeting so I can stay focused and engaged in the meeting itself, and then to summarize those notes, has really increased my productivity.
We know that in today's rapidly evolving tech landscape, you need divergent thinkers to help drive innovation and give your business a competitive edge. When you foster an environment where neurodiverse individuals can thrive, you're optimizing your workforce and shaping a more dynamic organization.
One of the principles with Microsoft is model coach care. And so you have to kind of live that method for anyone. And I think that's the beauty of having the neurodiverse program. We're not lowering our standards by any means. We're just making sure we're casting a wider net so we can find all the talent.
I've had the opportunity to work on a lot of amazing teams from Azure Spatial Anchors, now working on Azure OpenAI Services. Somebody neurodiverse coming through the program, working on these projects and working on these teams, like, you know, you're valued for what you bring to the table.
I've grown from this, my team has grown from this, and so I would like to see this program bring on more individuals so we can continue to grow as a company.
When I look back on the last 10 years, what I'm most proud of is how we've taken key learnings from the neurodiversity program to drive organizational change. We learned that true business impact comes from scaling these insights across the entire Microsoft enterprise so we can proactively attract, develop, and retain top neurodivergent talent.
I would say that companies that aren't looking at this talent pool are going to be really missing out in the next few years. There's so much heart in the way that neurodivergent individuals navigate the world. And if you are a supporter of those individuals and you value them, they will value you back.